going to read information about it from the wikifandom page and give a brief synopsis just in case anybody's not familiar with this wonderful franchise, because I quite frankly love it, and yeah, it's a wonderful, wonderful game, wonderful, wonderful franchise. If you're looking to get into anything, gonna start them in alphabetical order, except that I read to you guys. So, this is the shrine of Arkay. So, in the game, these 9 shrines are spread throughout the map of Skyrim. Honestly, super, super detailed. messages right now. I can't look at that. They're having fun, is all I can say. Okay, so the Arkay religion, there is a religious order who they see it as their duty to protect the souls of others, and through three consecrations given at birth, death, and after, to protect souls from manipulation. These are things that I believe you can find out about in the Elder Scrolls Online. And I played Elder Scrolls Online for a bit, but I stopped playing whenever it got a little bit buggy. I believe like towards the end of 2020, but I was pretty consistent for about a year. Miss it. magicka regenerate at 10% more. 10%. So let's read a tiny bit more about Akatosh, shall we? So Akatosh is probably one of my favorite divines in all of the game, because Akatosh is, I mean, there would be no divine quest where you find out that somebody's a worshipper, Diabella, and oh my god, she's like sleeping with so many people in town, and like the woman is working in her, and like basically outs her, and is like, she's screwing everybody. So, Diabella is the goddess of beauty, love, art, and music, and it's, and she, like many other ones, she some devoted to women, some to artists and aesthetics, and some even to erotic instruction. Yeah, not surprising. Okay, they are also known as the Passion Dancer, our Blessed Lady, and she has also been referred to as the Queen of Heaven. Wow. She must be great. I really need to be careful with what I say right now. To enchant the reader's ear and eye. She makes an appearance in almost every culture's pantheon and Skyrim. And in Tamriel. And at times she is affiliated. Says that Mara may have been the wife of Akatosh, and it is believed that she may also be Arkay's mother. However, it's unclear whether Mara was, in fact, the wife of Akatosh, the wife of Lorgon, or a concubine of both. We're not very sure. However, Mara's verse is, "Come to me, Mara, for without you, I might not forget. I might forget the ways of our fathers." Okay, so she hooked up with her homegirl's brother. Got it. Okay, so next up is Stendarr. I love this one. I think it's probably like my favorite looking one. Just because it's like, it's a little table. It's so cute. So Stendarr is the god of mercy and justice. Blessing a Stendarr by activating the shrine, which gives you block 10% more damage. So Stendarr is the god of righteous might and merciful forbearance. Curse for Stendarr is, come to me, Stendarr, for without you, I might be deaf to the man-swamp murmurings of thy people, and forgetting their need for comfort and wisdom, I might indulge myself in vain scribbling. And Stendarr, oh, that's so, I love this. Stendarr was named after Daggerfall beta tester Daniel Star. I'm sure worked very long hours and helped contribute to the finishing of these games. I love little Easter eggs like that. And probably that is a huge reason why I'm such a huge fan of the Skyrim franchise. And so, second to last, we have Talos. Talos is known as Deeper Septim, Ysmir Dragonborn, and the heir to the Seat of Sundered Kings, is the most important hero god of mankind. Much of his life as the mortal Diver Septim is shrouded in legend and hearsay, but one feat is undisputed. He became the first person to successfully unite all of the nations of Thimriel under a single empire. Single empire. Talos is worshipped as a protector and patron of just rulership and civil society, and his Nordic aspect of Ysmir is also seen as the patron of questing heroes. Honoring them. was the name of the legendary living bronze statue on Crete, built to guard the island of the command of Zeus, who was worshipped as Zeus. Talos in Crete. Okay, that's interesting. In addition, Talos is similar to another Greek figure, Arkay, as he was too immortal who ascended to divinity. And last but not least, Zenithar, the god of work, commerce, and trade. He preaches that his followers should work hard, be wise in their spendings, and never steal. He is almost always portrayed as male and is associated with the Bosmer Breton god Zen, as well as with the blue star that sometimes shines over Zemriel. Like his Adric brethren, he cannot directly interact with Nern, however he can influence it in his own way. Zenithar teaches to work hard, not for the material wealth it provides, but for the spiritual benefits. The fruits of our labor praise Zenithar, according to his priests and the empire. He is mainly worshipped as a god of merchants and middle nobility, appearing to give him a diverse group of followers. A common phrase spoken by worshippers is that Zenithar is the god that will always win. Zenithar is said to be closely associated with Kynareth, as the materials required for Zenithar's craftsmanship must be derived from Kynareth's natural world. Thus, one cannot revere Zenithar without acknowledging the power of Kynareth. This bond is shown when the divine crusader could only acquire the maze of the crusader, Zenithar's only known artifact, and wearing the boots of the crusader, which are associated with Kynareth. Zenithar's verse is, "Come to me, Zenithar, for without you, like a child, I might fiddle and fret. Only when through struggle and labor may I craft a work worthy of your name and the name of my patron." And Zenithar was named after Arena, Beta Tester, Stephen, Sen, Zap, with two P's. Well, my friends, and hopefully fellow fans of the Elder Scrolls, I hope that you very much so enjoyed this video, because I honestly really, really enjoy talking about stuff that I like, and if I got anything wrong, I apologize. Like I said, this is definitely something that I did kind of impromptu, to be honest, because I thought about doing another video. But I sat down to film and I was like, you know what? I don't want to just concentrate on making sounds. I would really like to like speak about something I like, revisit something that I really enjoy. And I've had these for so long and I really need to get them up. I really need to build a shrine for my shrines. So I think that'd be really cool. And now that my refrigerator has turned back on, this is probably a really good spot to end the video. But I am hoping to upload a little bit more consistently, because I do have a lot of ideas, I have a lot of things in the works, and I have some time, so we're gonna do it. But with that being said, thank you so much if you got to this far in the video, because I know it's gonna be a long one, probably the longest one I've ever made. And yeah, if you're not subscribed, please, please, please subscribe. I would absolutely love it if you would. I'm really getting close to hitting the goals that I want to be at, and I truly and honestly appreciate every single person that watches my videos, subscribes them, likes them, leaves a comment. Like, really, you have no idea how motivating it is to have that as somebody who watches a ton of ASMR and just really kind of fell into it because I love it as a community, as a way to relax, as a way for entertainment. Let's be honest, there's ASMR for literally everything under the sun, and if you're watching my videos, I am truly grateful from the bottom of my heart. I appreciate you. I appreciate the time that you take to watch. It's really, really cool to have that. And I am not at all ungrateful for it. And in fact, I am incredibly, incredibly grateful, and I appreciate so much. So, with that being said, I hope that you have a lovely, 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 lovely evening.